Hi guys, in this video I am going to discuss about how to download and install Cassandra on Windows operating system. So right here, first step is install JDK and set the path. So right here, let's open our command prompt and here just write at your Java C minus version. So it will give you the detail of which Java version is installed. So right here, currently Java C 1.8 install. Now hereafter we need to create at here a Java home and till JDK we need to paste. So right here, let's go on C drive. So here this PC. Now here you can find the C drive and here Java and here you can find JDK 8 and 12. Now here. Till this point, we need to copy this path and hereafter, let's open environment variable and hereafter, advanced system settings. So, I'm using Windows 10 operating system. So, at here, we need to do two things at this place. So, let's click this path and here, click on add it and here, done. So, see at here, Java JDK already. So you need to paste this at your location at the edit environment variable. Now hereafter I'm going to create at this place Java home. So at here let's write Java underscore home. Now hereafter paste this location Java C Java JDK. Now click on OK. OK. Now the next thing is at here. So when this part has been done, we need to install at here Python 2.7. So at here currently, let's write at here Python 2.7. Now here you can find all this. So this is the two older version and in current 3.7 is the current version. So at here Cassandra that support Python 2.7. So we need this at here. So here you can find download. And here zip Windows X and here you can find MSI installer 2.7. So at here 64-bit. So I'm using at here Windows or 10 64-bit operating system. So let's click this link. Now here the file size is at here 15.5 MB. Click on save file and now it's downloading. So it will take only 10 second times. So now it's done at here. Now click on open file and here OK. And hereafter it's going to install. So at here install all user, click next. And it must be installed in C and here Python directory. So now click on next and here no need to change. Click on next and here. And hereafter please wait. So it will take only a few minutes times. Now hereafter we need to download and here Cassandra. Okay, so in Google if you write Apache Cassandra, so here you get this details and here you can find this site. So I'm going to download and here latest Apache Cassandra. Manage massive amount of data fast without losing sleep. Click on download. To download latest Apache Cassandra 3.1, click this 3.1 and hereafter this link and here the file size is 39 MB, click on OK. So it's a downloading. Now hereafter the next is going to install Python. So it's done at here. Now hereafter let's go to C drive and or somewhere you can find just press P. Let's refresh. Okay, Python 2.7. Now here copy this link and here after go to environment variable and here path and here after do the editing of the path. Now here after let's give new and here set the path. Now here after click on OK. OK. Now here after let's add this point. Here if you write Python, so add here it's not recognized. So I'm going to open once again command prompt and let's write Python once again. Now here you get this information, that means Python 2.7 path has been installed successfully, state, and here Python installed successfully. Now here after the next is, so let's check. So right here, it's 1 minute left, so it takes time 1 minute, so I'm going to pause the video. Find Apache Cassandra bin.gz, so that is downloaded successfully. Now here after, let's go to download place. Now here you can find Apache Cassandra, so I'm going to do the extraction. So right here, extract here. Now here let's extract one more time. So yes to all, and here it's extracted. Here extraction part has been done. Now so this Cassandra let's paste in C-trap. So C-trap, so here it's pasted. Now here of click, and here you can find bin. Now here after copy this location and again go to add here, advanced system setting, environment variable and path. And here do the editing, and here after let's click on new button and save the path. Click on OK, OK, and OK. And here after the next thing is, so we need to add here just right. So this is not here. Let's open command prompt cmd. Now here we need to start the Cassandra. So add here, let's copy this one and paste. Press enter. So add here, it's starting the Cassandra. Cassandra with server, and here fully plans. So add here, it takes times to opening starting. This is command for starting. Now here after we need to get the tools. So let's copy this one. And here auto paste this place, and here if you press enter, so it will give the details about the tools. Ready track here. Now here after the next thing is, so we need to write at here cqlsh. Now here go to add this place and here press enter. So add here cqlsh. So add here, now it's come add here at this place cqlsh. Now here after you can create any kind of tables at this place. After I'm going to create the tables. So add here to create the tables. So add here, this is all command. So first we need to check add here key space. So let's write add here describe key space. So add here this key space are there. So we can use add here this kind of key space. So if you want, then here you can create the new key space. So add here, let's create the new space of giving add here test. Okay. Now here after we need to copy this one. Add here create key space test. The name is with replication. This all the things. Now here after let's press and here enter. Now here after you can see are new key space created with the name test. Now here after we can use this key space test, and here it's come now cqlsh and here test. Now inside I'm going to create add here table. So the add here the table name creating dev, and here it has two columns. Now here after, so here let's write this query, press enter. So here you can add here there is no error, there is no any error, and here you can find add here initializing test term. So key space created, and here here the table is created. Now hereafter I'm going to check is there any table with the name table. So add here, let's use select start from, press enter. So here you can find ID and name, and it has 20 rows. So if you want, then here you can insert the records. So add here, let's copy this one, and hereafter paste at this place and press enter. So now we got inserted 20 masses. Now you can see at here select start from table. So table one Sam, and here it's a record one row inserted. So this is the simplest way we can install Cassandra in Windows operating system. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you. Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss what how to connect Apache Cassandra with IntelliJ IDEA. So and here for this, let's go to database, and here you can find to plus. Click there, here data source. Now here you can find Amazon Redshift and Apache Cassandra Derby Hive Azure SQL. So you can connect with this all. So at here let's see about how to connect Apache Cassandra with IntelliJ IDEA. So at here clicking Apache Cassandra. Now here you can find this all those things. So add here data source and driver. So it's a selected by default host, that is localhost and port 9042. We need to download add here missing driver as well. So click on download. So it downloading two files. Now here after let's check. So add here it's starting the Apache Cassandra. Now here after let's open command prompt once again. Next is we need to write at here CQLSH. So press enter. Now at here driver that has changed. Now here up to we can write at here describe key spaces. Now press enter. So this key spaces is there. So I'm going to use add here S point. You can use anyone. Now here after the next is let's give the user. So again I'm going to write user Cassandra, and here give the password. Now here after we need to write add here key spaces. So at here let's write S point. Now if this all matching, then hereafter let's click on test connection. So if this all matching and write, so definitely it will connected. So it's a connected at here localhost port and your key spaces. Now hereafter click on OK. Now here there is so at here it's loading. So at here it's connected with key space S point. At here S point, and here you can find S point key space. So there is nothing inside there. So I'm going to connect at here once again with Cassandra. Select Apache Cassandra and give the user, and here give the password, and here this time I'm going to use the key space or test, because in our key space test there is some tables are there. Now hereafter let's give this time test. Now hereafter click on test connection. So it's succeeded. Now click on OK. And hereafter you can see Apache Cassandra with key space test is connected. Click this. Here you can find key space one, and inside test, and here you can find test is the key space, and inside there is one table with the name date, and if you click on James ID name, primary key ID, and here you can see from the center. So this is the simplest way we can connect Idea, IntelliJ IDEA with Cassandra, Apache Cassandra. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you. Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss about how to download and install NoSQL Manager for Cassandra. So in Google Idea you should write NoSQL Manager for Cassandra. Here you get to or MongoDB manager or site. So let's click that site. Now here after we need to go at your download button, and here after you get the link. So at your NoSQL manager for MongoDB professional, and here freeware. So at here I'm going to download and install NoSQL manager for Cassandra. So at here click this link and here click on save. Now here the file is downloaded, completed. Now hereafter let's click the exe file. So at here it will open. Now hereafter I'm going to command prompt, and hereafter let's write at here Cassandra minus f. So at here Cassandra is going to start. Now here after English it's selected. Here click on next, accept, next, yes, and here NoSQL, and here create icon, click on next and click on install. So at here extracting the files and installing at here. Now here you can see at here Cassandra is still starting. So if you're using at your like NoSQL manager, so first Cassandra must be installed in your laptop. So at how to install Cassandra, that I already discussed, so please watch my previous videos. Now here after it's a finish. Now there is an icon created with NoSQL manager for Cassandra. Now it's open. Now here after you can add here create new connection. So at here go to create, here you can find new connection, and here let's give add here host, that is local host. Now here after if you want, then here you can use authentication. So I'm going to give add here user Cassandra, and here give the password. Now here after if you want, then here you can use this place, and here so now here after you can check the advanced option. Now here let's click on, so and here let's give con gas. So this will name going to create. Now here you can see Concast, it's created, and here after it's connecting to the server. Now here you can find this key spaces, and inside the key spaces, and here this tables, user tab, and here user defined function. If you want, then here you can create the tables, and here so this is the one of the best GUID for Cassandra. So you should try and use this one. So this is the way we can use download, install, and hereafter configure NoSQL manager for Cassandra in Windows operating system. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you. Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss about how to import Microsoft SQL Server or database table inside Cassandra. So at here I'm using NoSQL manager for Cassandra. So by using this editor we can easily import Microsoft SQL Server table views, synonyms, and many more. So for this at here this is the expand is the key space. Now here right click on the tables, and here you can find import data from external database. So if you click there, so at here we have our two options. First is MS SQL Server database. So at here direct connect to MS SQL Server database. or we can use add here MySQL database. So let's select add here MS SQL Server database. Now here after click on next. Add here user to keep add here server name. So add here for server name. So add here I'm going to disconnect and connect. So copy this or server name and paste at this place. Now here after we have two way to the authentication. First is Windows authentication or SQL Server authentication. So if I select add here SQL Server authentication, we need to give add here username and password. So let's do the connection. So add here login and connecting, give the password, click on connect button. So it's connected and here you can find item database and here this all tables. So this all tables going to import inside Cassandra. Now here give the username SA and here give the password. Now hereafter you can select the database. So add here master tem, here msdb. So this three spots are system defined database. So I'm going to select add here Adam. Now hereafter click on next. And here this is the available tables are there. So if you want all, then here you can click double arrow. So it's all selected. Now if you don't want, then here. So if you want some particular or tables, so let's select add here this, not this one. So press control, hereafter you can select the tables. So you can select whatever you like from here. Now hereafter you should click add here this arrow, single arrow. Now hereafter it's selected. If you want any particular, select and here click this arrow. Now hereafter the next is click on next button. So add here this is source table name and here this is the destination table name. Now hereafter click on next and here bypass size 100. And if there is any table exit, so it will replace. Now hereafter click on execute. So add here first is failed because add here the table must have primary key. If the table have primary key, then that will import inside Cassandra. So this table don't have primary key. So add here if you press up here you get no primary key, so that it's a failed. But this table country and others has the primary key, so that no any problems. So add here it's done. So this or tables and here this one doesn't have any primary key, so that it doesn't import. So for importing table must have the primary key. Now here you can see this or table, it's come there. Now here after you can or do any kind of, or you can check the record. So here properties, here columns, and here index, employee ID, no trigger data. So this data here you can see the query. Now here after you can see add here name and here this all those things, here columns, index, and here data. Now here after if you right click, here you can use this add here select start from insert, and here if you want, then all this tables you can export also. So export or table data you can also do that. So this is the simplest way we can import external database tables inside Cassandra. So you should use add here NoSQL manager for Cassandra. After that you can easily do that. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you.
Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss about how to create the key space, alter the key space, and drop the key space in this video. So at here let's open first command prompt. And here first I'm going to start the Cassandra. So write Cassandra minus F to start the Cassandra. So right here it's starting. Now here after
I'm going to open NoSQL Manager. So about the NoSQL Manager that I already made the video. So at here it's starting. Now here this is the all those things. So at here create, alter, drop key space in Cassandra with example. So at here about the key space. So key space in NoSQL database is just like a schema database in RDMS concept. And here it holds column families index, user defined tabs and extra. And here this is the syntax. So at here this is the Microsoft SQL Server. So at here in Microsoft SQL Server we are using at here database. But if you are using at here or Cassandra, so at here we are saying that this is the key space. And here key space is the connection of it's connecting. So at here table user defined function. At here user defined tabs, aggregate function, materialized view, and many more. So let's see how to create the key space. So in our Cassandra, we can do anything by two ways. First is graphically, and here by second is by command prompt. So Cassandra, it's started going to create, sorry, going to open one more time. Add here command prompt, and you're going to change the directory CQLSH. Press enter. So it's changing the directory and here it's starting. Now it's changed. Now at this place we can create at here key space, tables, views and many more. So at here this is the syntax, create key space name with replication and here class. Strategy, so class can be two type, strategy name and network topology name. And here replication factor we can say 1 2 3 4 5, so number of replication on different nodes. So this is the one simplest example to create the key space. So at here create key space, name is Sony with replication, and here class simple strategy, and you can give the or replication function anything like 1 2 3. Now hereafter I just copied and going to paste at this point. Now if you press enter, so at here in 5 seconds at here there's no any error. So that means key space created. So if you want to check the key space, how many key space is there, so you should just execute this command, select start from system dot system underscore schema dot key spaces. Now hereafter paste and press enter. So at here this all our key space percent at there, and that I just created one key space Sony. So at here I just created Sony, and here you can see durable rights. If you don't give durable rights by default, then it to at here true. And here you can see simple strategy, and here number replication factor at here 1, because at here I have given 1. Now hereafter you can create at here key space by using network strategy. So at here this is the name Sony underscore network, and here with replication, and here this all this thing DC1 and DC2, and here making durable rights this time false. So let's copy that one and here paste and press enter. So key space created. Now hereafter select start from, you can check. So there is one key space this time created, and here since I have given the durable rights false, so right here you can see this is the false. Now here this is the two key space that I just created. Now here you can see this is the DC1, DC2, and here class that is network topology. So at here if you go NoSQL Manager, now if you refresh at here, so let's select this one. Here you can find, okay, do one thing, let's disconnect and connect it again. So if I double click, So it's a connected. Now here there are two KSPs. It's a created Sony network. Here if you go, so it's opening. Here you can see this all table, user tab, user, and this all those things. And here there is the one KSP that I just created with the name Sony. Now here you can see this all those things. Here you can create the tables inside there. Now here after the next is, so here we can do add here, like we can do the altering. So I'm going to do the altering on Sony KSP. So add here with replication. So add here replication is the one I'm going to change with 7. So by using alter command, we can do the modification. So add here, let's press enter, and here it's the done. Now here after select start from. So add here you can see Sony, and here this time replication factor 7. So that means add here KSP Sony is the alter. Now here after, so add here to validate KSP, you can use add here select start from this all those things. So add here to display or key space, so you can try it, describe, and here after key spaces. Now here after let's write and press enter. So this all key space presented as client system and here Sony and here this things. Now here after the last thing is, so add here we can drop the key space also. So add here we need to write drop key space. Now here after give the key space name. So add here let's press, and here I'm going to drop add here or Sony network. So let's write add here Sony underscore network. Now press enter. So it's executing the command. So add here operation timeout error. Okay, let's use add here this command. Here you can find Sony is not present there. So by using add here drop KSPs, we can easily drop the any kind of KSPs add here. Now here after, so this is add here command based. Now if you are using add here NoSQL manager, so we can create the KSPs add here also. Now here after, so add here Sony network is there. Now here after, so let's do add here reference. So add here you can find Sony network doesn't exist. That means that I just deleted. So here I'm going to disconnect, and here after connecting again. So after connecting, here you cannot find our Sony network KSP. So we can get the KSP by right click. Here you can write, and here you can give the key space name. So add here giving Sony key space. Now here you can change the replication factor. So let's give 4, and here this is the simple key space, and here this is the network topology. Now here you can, if you make that enable, so here that will true or comes true. Now if you press OK, so add here there is a Sony key space that is added. So like this you can add here get the key space or use network, and here you can use DC. So here you can give data center 1, and here you can change the value. Now here let's give data center 2, and here going to give add here 4, and if you click OK, so here there is the key space 1 that is added. Now here after let's check that by command select start from, and here you can see this key space Sony key space, and here key space 1. So I did not enable or deliver that, so that it's a false, and here DC 1 as the value 2 data center, and data center 2 value 4. Like this you can add multiple data center. So this is the simplest way we can create add here key space in Cassandra. So key space is just similar to, so we are saying annual relational or DBMS database, but NoSQL we are saying key space. NoSQL Cassandra, we are saying key space. And key space is the collection of tables, user tabs, aggregate function, materialized view, and many more. So I hope, guys, this video is helpful for you. So now in this video, it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you. Hi, guys. In this video, I'm going to discuss about how to create table in Cassandra. So at here, this is the basic syntax. And here, create table. And here, key space name and dot table name. And here, you can give n number of columns. And at least one column must be primary key. So about the key space that I already discussed. So at here you can check the fifth video how to create key space in Cassandra. Now hereafter, so this is the syntax, and hereafter we need to go at here CQLSH. Now here this is the command prompt, and here this all at here this all key space. So we can use at here or any key space at this point. Now here let's scroll down. So here you can see in last video I did so many operations. So let's use at here Sony key space. So you can write at here use Sony and close my semicolon. So at here now whatever you are creating table, so it comes under Sony key space. So at here you can see create table and here this all those things. So here let's copy that, and here after paste this one. So at here create table emp, id is the primary key, name text tag, and your city. Now if you press enter, so at here the table is created. So here after we can use at here select a statement. So at here let's write select a star from, and here emp table. Now if you press enter, so here you can see three columns is there, id, and here city and name. Now hereafter I'm going to insert the record. So at here we can use at here select insert into, and here let's copy and paste it here. So here one more thing we need to or change at here emp doesn't exist. So I just created one table with the name emp. So here this is the emp one. Now here after let's copy, and here going to paste. So press enter. So there is no any problems. So here let's use select statement. So at here there is a one. At here record added 113 Cardiff and JSON. Now hereafter you can insert multiple record. So at here select here you need to do only modification. Here I'm going to enter Cardiff 1 and JSON 1. Now if I press enter, now hereafter let's use select start from emp. So at here record doesn't inserted because at here id is the primary key and primary key unique. So only one. So since at here id is the primary key, so 113 must be unique. So at here 113 at here it's the same, but at here record added new record Cardiff 1 and JSON 1. So it was at here Cardiff and JSON. So this is the difference at here. Now here after let's insert unique record 114 and here giving the name at here Perth and here giving the name semi. Now press enter. So record inserted, use select a start from. So here you can see 114 and here city Perth and the name is semi. Now here after the next thing is, so at here this is the way we can at here create the tables. Now here after to drop the tables, so we can use at here drop table emp. And there is one more thing. So whatever I did the change, I did the things inside command prompt, so it actually affected to at here on no SQL manager for Cassandra. So let's disconnect and connect it again. And here you can see Sony And here you can see one table, it's created with the name EMP. If you double click, here you can see ID, name, ID, city, name. Now here this three is columns and here indexer. So there is the one primary key ID, no trigger, and here this is the data. Now here you can open SQL. So this is opening SQL and here create table, and there is so many things here. Now hereafter I'm going to delete this EMP table. So here let's use drop and drop table EMP. Now hereafter let's go to command prompt and here press enter. So press enter. Now here the table is deleted. When I use select start from, so here you can get the message unconfigure table EMP. So this is the thanks here. Now hereafter let's open CMD command prompt and here let's write sqlsh. Press enter. Now hereafter we can create the table by using at here, like go this way. So at here sqlsh, go to sqlsh and hereafter you can create the table, create table s point. Now let's copy that one and hereafter let's paste. So at here using s point, so press enter. So at here there is a one table created inside EMP. So you can use at here directly sqlsh and here give the key space name and dot table name. Now here you can, if you want, then here you can see the refresh at here. So here let's disconnect and connect it again. Now here go to S point and here you can see one table it's created with EMP. And it has three column ID, city and name. So this is the way we can create the table by at here command prompts. Now here we can use at here NoSQL manager to create the tables. So simply you need to select at here any key space. So let's select at here EMP. Right click and here you can click on connect. Now here right click and here create new tables. Now hereafter let's give at here table name as student. Now hereafter let's add the columns. So here you can see add columns. So at here this is for role and here number. Now it should be numeric. So at here going to select decimal. Now here you can see query alter table student roll number decimal. Now hereafter click OK. Now hereafter the next thing is we can add multiple. So let's give out here a student name. So you can give out here varchar or text. So here you can find varchar and here let's click on OK. And here let's give address this time and you can give at here text here or you can use at here partition key. Now hereafter you can see the indexes and here this is the query create table student here roll number decimal and here you can see primary key automatically it's created. So at here it has two primary key, roll number and address. If you want, then here you can remove that one. You can give at least one primary key. Now hereafter the next thing is we need to execute this one. So here you can see apply changes. So at here you can see at here create table student here primary key two columns it's selected and here this all those things. Now hereafter so at here you can see at here table it's created. Now hereafter the next thing is we need to insert the record. So at here use zendit command and here zendit insert into. So at here you can see this automatically it's come there. So here we need to give at here first is roll number. So let's give 12112 and here next is we need to give at this point address. So in single code, so here you can see no any execution times, no any problems. So we need to give at here when you are using NoSQL Manager Cassandra. So here you should keep at here single code for a string values. Now here after, so here right click, and here you can generate, and here you can use select statement. Select. Now if you execute this one, so at here 112 and your cartridge max is added. Now here you can change the record. So let's give this time 113, and here let's give for city address at here Miami, and here giving the at here student name or Jason. Now here if you execute this query, so execution time 5 seconds, there is no any problems. Now if you execute this one, so add here one more record, it's added. So this is the way we can create the tables by using command prompt. Here by using command prompt, and here by using GraphQL editor NoSQL Manager. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you. Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss what how to use DB schema editor for Cassandra. So add here in Google Drive DB schema download. Add here you get dbschema.com. Now let's click this link. And here you can find download DB schema. So add here free evaluate. So this is for 15 days. And here this is available for Windows, Linux and Mac. And here this is the current version, and here 64-bit installer, and here so first you should download and install ZDK 12. Now hereafter let's click on installer. So and here the file size is 152 MB, and here this is the exe file. Now let's click on save, and here it's so downloading. So that I already downloaded DB schema 8.1, so I'm not going to download once again. So let's click cancel, and here after let's click on open file. So add here DB schema installer, extracting DB schema installer files. Now add here welcome to DB schema setup wizard, click on next, and this location where or DB schema going to install. See program files DB schema, and here this is the space required 298 MB. Click on next, and here create or start panel. So it's fine DB schema. If you want, then here you can select other. So let's click on next, and here DB schema project file here dot DBS, or you can use SQL query file. Click on next. And here this is preparing to install. Completing the DB schema setup wizard, here run DB schema create icon. So let's click on finish. So right here DB schema it's opening. Now add here, so let's close that. And here this is the editor. Now first I'm going to connect to Cassandra. So one more thing, let's open command prompt, and here after let's write Cassandra minus L. So by using this command Cassandra will start. Cassandra is starting. Now hereafter let's minimize, and hereafter click on connect to database, and here you can select to add here RDBMS. So if you select add here, here you can find Cassandra, MongoDB, Oracle. So let's click add here Cassandra. So add here downloading driver from the dbschema.com. So add here 50% done. So at here installing JDBC, so it's completed I think, and here after loading the drivers. So if you are using first term, so you need to do this. Now here after Cassandra is selected, and here after the next thing is, so at here localhost 9042, so automatically it's taken database Cassandra and here, and here after we need to select at here key space. So there are different key space are there, so here you can see this key space. So I think let's select at here Sony key space. Now here you can, by clicking this, you can view the password. So at your Cassandra it's fine. Now here after click on connect. So at here connected. Now here tick checkbox schema to reserve the engineer. So key space we need to select. So let's select at here Sony. Now here after click on OK. So here you can see key space. So there is one table inside there. And here this is at here ER diagram. And here this is here student. So it has three columns. Now if you right click, so at here right click, then you can create the tables. And here you can find the path. Now here after right click, then you can create the key space here. Now here after you can open the query editor. So need SQL editor, open SQL file, this kind of option we have. Now here after the schema, if you go here create table view, here create table, by using this you can easily create the table. So at here give the table name, here after set columns, and here after you can make the primary foreign key check constant at here. So this is the one good ID for Cassandra. So this is the simplest way we can use Atrium or DB schema for Cassandra. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you.
Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss what insert into update and delete operation in Cassandra. So at here this is the first is insert into. So at here this is the basic syntax for insert into. Insert into here, keep the key space name, table name, and your column, and here to values, and here or column values you should keep, and here use Sony. So at here or at here Cassandra is started by using Cassandra minus F command. Now here after let's use at here NoSQL manager for Cassandra. Now at here if you want to do any update, okay, or insert. So you should use at here by using NoSQL manager. So it's the very easiest process. So at here let's right click, and here after you should go generate command. Here you can find insert into, here go to SQL editor. So at here now we need to here insert the record. So first I'm going to see the record. So at here let's use select star from student all field. Now here after let's execute to this query. So at here it has two rows inside. So I'm going to insert one more. So let's give at here 115. And here next is address. So at here giving address in single quote Cardiff. Now here after let's use next is a student name. So giving at here in single quote Jenny. Now here after, so select this query, and here you can find execute selected, click on. So at here execution time no any error. Now if you want to see the record, select this all, and here you can see at here 115, and here Cardiff and Jimmy, that record inserted. So here you can see this things. So this is the syntax for insert. Insert into, so key space that I'm using, here you can find Sony, and here after columns, and here this values. So like this you can insert at here multiple records. So just control C, and here do control P,
control V. Now you need to change only add your ID. So add your 116, next giving add your 117. And because add here this ID is the primary key, so we can insert only unique record. So add here command completed, no any error found. Now here after execute that, here you can see 115, 116, 117, that record add here it's a display. So this is the easiest way we can add here insert. Now for delete, right click, add here generate command, here you can find add here. Okay, let's do some update first. Update, now here select update student set roll number address and here name. So add here we need to provide add here roll number and address. So roll number and address we need to provide because add here these two are or composite primary key. Now add here giving address or first is roll number, so 115. And here, so let's give add here Cardiff. Cardiff, now here after, so add here where. So I'm going to do the update. So add here, let's 115, it's okay. Now here I'm going to change the address Cardiff to Mexico. Mexico, now close by single quote, and here a student name, here I'm giving a Smith. Now hereafter if it's done, let's select and execute. So at here I'm getting something like at here primary key roll number found in set part. Okay, so if the primary key add here roll number, so we cannot do this one. Okay, now here after let's execute once again, and here our address is also the primary key, so we cannot insert add here when that is primary key, so we cannot. Now after executing, so it's done add here. Now here after we can use add here select command. So add here select from a student, add here all field. Now here after let's execute. So add here you can see, so 115, add here name that change, add here address. So add here for update when both these two condition is match. So 115 and Cardiff match. So add here previous name was something else, now it changed with Smith. Now here after the next is, so this time I'm going to use add here key space S point. Now here after let's use add here score.dpt. Now here you can do the update. So add here update. Now here after let's see the record. So add here select a star from add here score.dpt. Now here let's execute that, so this records inside there. Now here after here if I go generate open, so primary key is the DPT number, so we should exclude this DPT number from here. Now here after we can set add here dname and log. So add here going to change the DPT 30 and your dname with HR. So let's give inside single quote HR. Now hereafter location giving at here Chicago 1. Now hereafter if you execute this query selected, so no any error found. Now if you execute here, so here you can see dname change with HR and the location is at your Chicago. So this is at your for update. Now next is at your for delete. So at here this is update, update key space, table name set, And here, this, when the condition is matched, then that will update. Now, here after, this is for delete. So, at here, delete from here, key space, table name, here, column, and here, when that match. So, at here, or let's copy this. And here, so this time, going to use this one. So, let's paste at here, and here, this is now check the record inside a student. So at here delete from student and here their roll number. Not this one. Now here after. Okay, let's do at here delete. So I'm going to select this point a student and here go to generate and here you can find delete. Execute this query, so at here delete from a student via roll number. So we need to give at here roll number and here or address because these two are composite primary key. So at here giving the roll number 115 and here address. Address is Cartel. Now here after if you execute this query. So at here execution completed. Now here after you can use at here select command to check the record. Select from student all fields. Now here after execute that. So 115 that gone. So like this you can use at here this or dpt and here you should try it at here generate and here delete. Now here delete from only you need to give at here dpt number. So at here, if I give at here 30, so let's check that. So at here execution completed. Now hereafter, let's use at here select from and here escort.dpt and all fields. Now if you execute, so 30 is no more in the list. So this is the way we can at here insert, update, and delete our query we can perform inside Cassandra. So at here if you are using NoSQL Manager, so it's very user friendly. By using this you can easily at here do the SQL query kind of operation inside Cassandra. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you in next video. Thank you.
Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about how to create and drop index in Cassandra. So at here, this is the NoSQL Manager for Cassandra and this all are key spaces. Now here after I'm going to open. So at here, Cassandra minus F. So by using this command, so at here, Cassandra that started. Now here after, let's open command prompt once again. And here, let's write CQLSH. CQLSH. Now press enter. So that by using this command, so at here directory change, it comes under CQLSH. Now here after I'm going to create the tables first. So at here create table. Now copy and paste here. So at here create table SPint. So SPint is the key space and here emp is the table. And here id, integer tag, name, text type and here that I said primary key and here ct text. So if I press enter. So at here there is no any problems. So that means at here table ENP created on site S point. So at here if you click there, so ENP is not there. So let's refresh S point. Now here you can see ENP. So if I double click on ENP, here you can see indexes. So at here since I have set primary key on name, so there is a one or key index that is created at here on column name. Now here after the next is going to insert some record inside EMP table. So let's copy that one and here paste. Press enter. So at here why I'm getting invalid to EMP. Okay, we need to use at here use S point. Okay, S point is the key space. Now here after paste again. So at here, this time there is no any error.
Now here after let's use add here select add here id column and id city and name. Now here after let's use so this time add here four rows inserted. Okay. Now here after I'm going to do the filtering. Okay, select star from add here. Star that takes all the columns from EMP. Now here after going to use. Now press enter. So this time add here I'm getting the error message select star from EMP where ID. So ID is not a primary key and it has no stated any indexes. So that here I'm getting the message. So you can treat invalid request and here cannot execute this invoking filtering thus unpredictable performance. If you want to execute this query despite performance, so use allow filtering. So we can use allow filtering. So right here it's not filtering because ID column has not set with primary key or no any indexes. So that I'm going to get the index on ID. So right here let's create the index. Here this is the syntax. Create index, index name on key space table and here columns. So add here create index giving the name IDX on SPAT is the key space on EMP table and here ID going to set with ID. Now here after let's paste at here press enter. So add here no any error, that means index is created. Now here you can if I refresh S point, so it's refreshed. Now here after you can see IDX, that is index. IDX is the name of index created on the column ID. Now here after the next thing is, so now here after I'm going to use this query once again. So let's see at here. So copy and here you can just paste and press enter. So this time add here a record filter. So add here ID 115, add here city and name, according to that it's a display. So it's a add here a filter the record because add here I just set index on the ID column. So if you do add here set index add here on ID column, so it's a very easily you can filter. So add here to filter any records on the column is two conditions. Add here first the column has primary key or you can set the index. So if you set index then you can filter the columns records. Now hereafter so this is the simplest way we can create the index. So add here only you need to write add here create index. Here give the index name and here on SPAT is the key space and here EMP. And here specify the column name. Now here after to drop the index. So okay, let's copy and here paste. Now at this point and here paste. So at here drop index if it checks exits and here S point and here IDS is the index name. Now here after if I do select star from ID, so again the error message because ID not set with any ID has no any index at here. So this is the thanks. So that's why we are using at here or we are creating the index to filter the records. And here after the next thing is let's go to at here NoSQL Cassandra Manager. Now here after if you do filter, so at here you can see at here or IDX or no more at this point. Now here after I'm going to get the index at here. So at here EMP, right click on EMP. Here after here you can find, so not this one. Okay, let's right click. Here you can see right click on EMP generate. Here create index secure. Now here you can see create index and here this give the name. So at here new index is the name. You can give at here new IND and which columns. So at here there are so many columns, three columns are there. So let's write at here select select from, and here going to select emp all field. Now here after emp, now if I execute this query, so add here id city name, so going to give add here id. Okay, now here after create index, now execute this query. So add here index is created. Now here after double click, so we need to replace. Okay, let's replace here. Now here new id index created on the id columns. Now here index is created. Now here after you can use add here. Now here this time record is filter. Now here after I'm going to drop index once again. Drop, and here the index name, name, and here id. So let's just check the index name first. New ind, new ind. So no any error. Now here after do one thing, let's replace case space. So add here replace. So new underscore id is 10 has new underscore ind, that's why it is still there. Now press enter. Now here after let's refresh once again. So this time index is normal.
Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about how to list all Cassandra tables. So and here you can see Cassandra by using Cassandra minus F, Cassandra started. Now here after the next thing is, let's open command prompt, and here I'm going to go inside sqlsh. So inside there we can write at here Cassandra command. So add here first is describe all tables and key space. So if you use add here describe tables, so here let's execute, and here you can see. So add here let's go up. So key space expand, you can find this all tables, and here key space system schema, you can find this all those things like tables, taken, views. Now here system dot auth, here you can find this all those things, and here Sony key space, that is empty. Now let's, and here after you can find add here key space, this all those things like ps batch log, hits, local paros, and here key space system trash event session, and here this is the empty here. And here Sony key space has only one table, a student. So if you want, then here you can check all key space. So by using describe and here write key spaces. So here this all key spaces is there. So key space just equal to DBMS, sorry, database. So in RDBMS we can say add here or database, but if you are using Cassandra we are saying key space. Now here after the next is to get add here get key space info. So you can use add here select as dot from system schema here key spaces. Now if you execute the or this query, so here by using this we can get the key space info. So here S point, here this is the durable rights, and here replication. So some are simple and some are add here network topple. Let's see. So about this, all these things, when I started making tutorial of Cassandra, they are discussed. Now here after the next is get table info. So here we can use this things, let's copy this query first. So select start from system underscore schema table, and here where key space underscore name. So add here key space
So I just filter S point. Now if you press enter, so here you can get everything inside of S point case space. So add here S point, here case space name S point, and here table name HR country, department, employees, job, location, region. And if you are using, here you can see table, and here filter, caching, compression, this all those things are there. Now hereafter let's see other query. Now next add here get table info. So here you can use add here. So here you can, I have given condition S point, so it only display tables views inside S point. Now here let's use table info. So we can use add here system schema dot columns. Now here after let's paste and press enter. So here you get this all columns inside there. Okay, so they are this all are add here. Here you can see S got table has this all columns like S got this ENP, this all columns are inside SCOT. So here by using columns, so it's a return at here column info on the table. Okay, this all columns, there are so many things are displaying. More press enter, so it's all displaying. So there are so many columns inside there. So like this you can use at here tables. Now press enter, so this all tables inside there. So here you can see this add here of index, add here percentile, chuck, duplicate, this sort. Now let's go up. So add here table key space name, table name, and here CDC, all those things it's displaying at here. So here you can see case space S point, HR country. Now inside HR country you get at here this all info, and here HR department, this all info is displaying at here by using tables. Now let's see other query. So at here, so I don't know how to display this all contents, because this all contents are very bigger and not very user friendly to understand. So you can use at here key space. So it's all taking, it's displaying all key spaces at here. So I'm going to do the filtering. So at here key space name S point and table name S dot. So only S dot table content that will display by using this query. So at here column. Now here after press enter, so here you can see with values are displaying are very simple. So add here case space S point, table name ENP, this all columns, and here no ordering, bytes taken, kind, partition. So this is add here partition, position, tabs, data tabs that using commission, decimal, and here ename that is text tabs. So like you can use at your other key space answer. Now here let's give at your Sony. So at here when I given system, no variable alternative here. So at here when I give Sony, so let's use at your describe, and here key space. So at here you can find Sony, but at here this condition is not matching. So inside of Sony, so at here you can use first command to get the table info. So at here let's go up key space. Now let's go, okay, here is Sony, the table name at here student. Now we can use at here So K space, it's Sony, it's right, and a table name that is a student. Now you get the right info. If you press enter, so add your key space name Sony and table name student. Okay, I'm doing one mistake here. So we need to write complete query. Okay, so let's copy this one and hereafter. So add here, let's give for key space name Sony and your table name student. Now hereafter copy this query and add here I'm not getting right output because add here it's creating the query on where. So we need to write add here write query. So here copy this one and paste at this place. Now press enter. So here inside Sony, here table name student, this all columns, and here bytes kind, and here tag it's display. So this is the way we can display list of all Cassandra table key spaces columns inside table. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you. Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about how to fix user defined function or disable in Cassandra. So at here when you create any user defined function, so it's okay fine. Now if you click at here apply changes, now at here getting the error message user defined function or disable in Cassandra, set enable and true. So how we can do this? Or if you go add your command prompt, now let's open command prompt and here let's write cqmsh. Now add here going to create one user defined function. So add here create user defined function, copy this one. Now here after let's press and here press enter. So add here getting the message. So add here the function must be function add here. So add here this is the problem related to key space. So add here let's use first use s point. Now here after paste once again. Now if you press enter, so this time getting the error message. So add here user defined function or disabling Cassandra. Yeah. This all these things. So how to fix this kind of situation? So simply you go add here. So go to where the Cassandra is in your PC. So in my PC, Cassandra or is on C drive. Here Apache. Now go to config folder, and here you can find Cassandra and your YAML source file. Right click and here go to, you can open with notepad or you can open with any editor. Now here you can, you should go at here this all those things. Now here you can dump. Now at this place you need to say at here enable user defined function. So by default it's a false, so you should make that true. Now here after enable script user defined, so this is for script. Now let's make that add here to this one also. Now here enable materialize view, it's fine, true. And here no need to change anything else. Now here after click on save and exit. And here after you need to do one thing, cancel. And here cancel. And hereafter let's open command prompt and here write Cassandra minus app to start Cassandra. Now hereafter it's starting. Now hereafter let's do disconnect save function no. So that's disconnected. Now wait for Cassandra to restart. Now let's open ITAP command prompt once again. So command prompt, it's open. Now it takes only 10 seconds to restart the Cassandra. So it's the end process. Info main add here this all tables, all those things. Now escape playback. So there are so many things inside there. Now here after, let's check, is it Cassandra? Not started yet. Now here after, let's check, started. So here you can find start RPC. So that means Cassandra is started, I think. Now click, double click add there. So add here it's connected. Now here after, when I'm trying to create add here, user defined function. So click add here. Now create user. Now if you click on tick. So add here, when I click on tick, so this time there is no any problem. So that means add here. Or this time this kind of issue that fixed. Now if you go add here command prompt. So let's write at here cq lsh. Now here after using spint kspace. So at here let's write is use spint, or you can use at here sony kspace. Now it's the inside sony. Now here after let's copy this function and here paste and paste enter. So there is no any problem this time, and here function it's created. So let's go at here Sony. Now if you refresh, here you can see two user defined function is created. One is Sony function and here concat. Sorry, at here function one and here concat. So if I take the cursor at this point, here create or replace function it's the display. So this is the way we can fix the issue. So I hope that this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you. So guys, today I'm going to discuss about how to create function and why do we need function in Cassandra. So add here this example that I already written. So if you execute this query, select start from HR employees. So HR employees that comes inside spint. So if you are using Cassandra GUI NoSQL manager, here you can see spint is the key space and here HR employees, here you can find. Now here after the next is, so let's use at here use spint. Now here after, if you execute this query, select start from, now press enter. So it's a displaying at here all the record inside employee. Now here you can find first name and here last name at this space. So at here it's looking bigger. So let's use at here Cassandra. Okay. Now here after let's go to tools tab and we're going to use CQ analysis. Now here after this query going to use at this place. And here after let's execute that. So here this is the record inside HR employees table. So if you want to combine at your first name and last name, so at here you can use at your function. So this is the query that I already written to save some time. So at here create or replace function. So let's copy this one first and here paste at this position. So at here the query is create or replace function. The name is concat and your first name that is text and your last name that is text. You can use that here str, str1 and str2. Now here after taking a string tag variable name and here it's combining two at here or text columns. So at your first name and last name and that return name. Now if I execute this query, so So first we need to select this one, it's selected. Here you can find execute selected. So at here executing, it's executed and it has no any problem. So if I go at here S point here inside, so first we need to refresh that. So here you can find concat function, it's a created. So this concat function we can apply on different tables. So let's use at here employees table. Okay, so employees table, this all those things here. So here going to copy this query and let's paste at DOM. Now here, so selecting at here employee ID and here concat function going to use, and here in concat function and here passing first name. So at your first name and last name, I'm passing. Now if I execute this query, so at here it's now concatenated to first name and last name, it's a display. Or you can include at here at this space first name and here last name. Now it will give the, so at here I'm doing some mistake, we need to give at here comma. Now press execute once again. So at here center column concatenated this values is man senior. Here it's this value tj of song. At here tj also needs to this one. Now here after the next important thing is, so we can use at here this concat function with the different tables. So at here this is, now here after we can give at here three parameter also. So suppose if I give at here in this example, so let's check at here first all the columns inside employees. So at here when it's not necessary you can give at here first time and last time, you can include at here email too. So let's give at here email double quote. Here you can find just paste email. Now here email is also text tag. Now here after, so I did not include at here last name. So let's give at here at this place email. So all are in capital letter. Now if you execute here, so it's now combined center, this is the email and here it's combined here. So you cannot give at here concat function has only two parameters, so you should give only two parameters, you cannot give more than two parameters. So when I give at here at this place last name, okay. Now if I execute, definitely I will get the error. So at here invalid argument call function. So at here our column must be at this place text tab and it has only two parameters. Now at here for three parameters have different query. So that there I return the query, the function name concat2 three parameter. On here you can write str1, str2. So if I give at here str1, so it's taking more time, so I'm not going to do that. Let's add here, we need to modify every place. So wherever our first name, that place you can write str1, str2, str3 like that. Now here after, let's copy this one. Now here after let's paste at this place. Now here after let's execute this query. So at here executed, no any problem. If you replace KSpace, here you can find another concat2 function, it's created. Here this is the query at this place. Now concat function, it's created. Now here after we can use this concat function on different tables. So let's use at here HR. So let's copy that one and here paste at top, and here you can see this all the columns here, first name, last name, and here giving email. So here let's execute here. So it's combined three columns. So why do we use add here concat function? So you can create one tag, and this concat function you can apply in different tables. So you can use emp, emp2, add here different tables, you can use that. So add here they are using emp, okay, like so if I execute this term, so this term going to use add here escort emp table. So here let's execute here, this is the all columns inside emp table. Now hereafter you can use also extra in place of all the columns. So this is the columns. Now you can combine add here to text type or a string value. So you can combine ename and job. So for this you can go add here concat function. So concat one has only two parameters. So if you want, then here you can combine. So only you need to write add here select a star from add here which escort emp. So all field that is selected, and here we need job and ename. So let's remove other part. Now hereafter let's give comma, and here you can use concat one, and here you can combine ename and job. So let's write at here ename comma and here job. Now close that. So by using at here concat, now let's execute. So here getting the right output as called list, it's combined. So here one time declared, and we can use on different tables, views, synonyms, materialized view, and anything. So this is the benefit of function one time create and many time use. So it has only two parameters, so it will accept at this place two columns. It will not accept more than two. Suppose at here when I try to encode to any other columns, so it will not accept. Like if I give at here only one columns, so definitely it will return the error because argument not matching argument this kind of things it will display. So this is the reason at here to create the function. You can create the function at concat one. You can use at your different tables, and if table has so views or synonyms and materialized view, you can use this function in other. So that's why we are using here, and this is the simplest example to create at here or create the function. You can use this all those things. And here, this is the simplest query unity pass. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you. Hey friends, today I'm going to discuss about how to concat or two or more than two columns in a table. So right here I'm going to use employees table. So let's write the query select. And here you can find select extra. So there is no any store HR employees. All fields, that's fine. Now hereafter, let's select and execute. So this all columns inside there. Now here after, so I'm gonna combine add here email, first name, last name, So if you want, then here you can combine Java ID. This all those things. So how do we combine? So for this add here, let's add here use this query. So this query that I already written to save some time. So add here creating the function with the name concat add here. So let's copy this query. And you have to paste at this place. Now here after let's go at here. So select start from. So it will display all the columns. So at here create a replace function called cat. So at here first name and last name. So going to create at here one function with the name called cat one. And here string name first name and last name. Now if I execute this query, so add here function it's created with the name concat1. Now after refresh that, so add here function it's created. So this function we can use add here different tables. So add here going to use add here employee or HR employees tables. Now here after let's copy this one. And hereafter paste at this place. Now here concat function. So at your first name and last name it's come from HR employees. So let's execute this query. So here you can see. So at your first name and last name. So here you can find first name and last name. So these two columns we are going to concatenate. So let's execute here ID it's displaying and first time and last time it's combined. Now here after you can all combine at your different tables, different columns at here. So here it's not necessary you can give at your first time, last time you can give at your email also. So let's use Java code and your pass. Press enter. Now here after execute here you can see center, so email and first name that combined. Now here after, so if you want then here you can combine more than two of columns. So suppose if I here I have given the condition first name and last name, so string one and string two. Now if you keep add here like interval code going to use last name two. Now here if I execute this query, so at here argument related kind of error message it's on display. So we need to skip at here right number of argument. So if you want to combine three at here three columns, so you should use this query. Now hereafter let's copy and execute first. Now here after execute, now here it's executed. Now here after, so do one thing, let's refresh at here s point key space. Now here you can see concat2 it's created. Now here after, so when I use this query on concat one function, so it only accept two parameter. Now here concat two that accept three parameter. Now if I execute, so it will give at here right output combined first name, email and last name. So at here because at here concat two it has three parameters, so that it to combine three. Now here after, so it's not necessary you can give first name, email, last name. So at here this all values are text type, so you can include only text or string kind of value at this place. Okay, so this is the simplest query to concat or two or more than two columns here. So if you want to concatenate integer type value, so you should give at here or decimal or id UUID or integer add here. After that you can combine integer kind of values. So I hope that this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you.
In this video, I'm going to discuss about Cassandra collection data types like list, set, and map. So about Atlas set connection. So it stores group of element that return sorted element when queried. So let's understand by example. So first I'm going to create the tables. So at here by using Cassandra minus F. So by using this command, we can start the Cassandra. And if you write at here sqlsh, now commands comes to sqlsh under. Now if I paste and if I press enter, so here there is a one table created with the name emp. So s point is the at here s point, so it's a key space. Now here after I'm going to check the record inside emp one table, select s star from get the key space name s point. Now here after emp one, now there is no any record inside emp1. Now here after I'm going to insert some record, so let's copy that one. Now here after paste and press enter. So here you can see one record, enter the id 114 and your email and the name. Now here after I'm going to insert at here. So this time at here I am providing three email. Now here in record inserted. Now here you can see at here. So ID here, this is the email and the name Jordan. So at here by using set command, it stores group of element that return sorted element when queried. So at here it return group of elements. So at here we can insert group of element. So one time we can insert multiple email by using at him set connection, and here it return sorted elements. So when I insert this value, so this is on order. So after applying at him set on email. So here you can see set and your text tab. So this at him is now in sorted format. So here you can see C, Z, and Z. So this is why we can use at here. Now here after insert into s point and here emp1 id name email and here values. So this value is going to enter and here the first letter is s and here. So after inserting at here the first time n will come here after s. Now here after let's press enter. So here after let's check the record inside there. So select s dot from here you can see n is now first time here, n lost is now at here s, n lost now it's come first and here s first it's now come last. So that's why we are using at here set operator. So first at here this return at here or sorted element and we can insert multiple values here. Now here after like this ID name 114 Nissan and here this value. So if I enter duplicate values, so let's see what happened. So at here name at the rate gmail.com, so it's two times and here it's a duplicate. Now press enter and here check the record. So here you can see it accept only one name. So I inserted two times but it accept only one name. So that's why at here it store, that means it stores unique values. Now here after let's see about the list connection example. So at here value sorted in the list don't need to be unique and can be duplicate. So when I enter at here, when I make the column or set, we cannot insert duplicate, but by using at here list connection we can insert at here duplicate values. So at here you can see I applied list on bronze. Now here after first I am going to create the table. Now here after press enter. So there is a one table. It's created with the name emp table. So at here s point create table. Now here after let's
give emp2, so no any flows. Now here after, let's insert some values. Now here press enter, so value inserted. Now here you can see, so and here 118, and here you can see this is an unsorted format. But when I enter at here on set, so it store the value on sorted format. So for first at here there's a difference between list and set. So at here list unsorted, set sorted. Now here after we can insert this value here. Let's check that. Now press enter, so value inserted. Now here after select, here you can see. So one first time that I inserted 118, 122. Now here you can see there's two parameter and here s size. So at here it now at here sees the first it's come first, sees the when you count at here ABC, C come first, S last. But at here by using list we can whatever we insert the same value that accept. So this is the things. Now here after let's do one thing. So at here I'm going to insert some duplicate values. So now let's see what happened. Now here after let's so see at here. So it's a displaying CS trash tags. So that means at here it is store duplicate values. List that is store duplicate value. So this is the things. Here between list and set, set accept only unique and list accept duplicate. Now here after we can use this also by using list and your set. So now here after let's create the table. The table name emp3 and your table created. Now here after let's check the record inside emp3. No any rows inserted. Now here after, so at here also here, so when I enter at here or set, we can give at here curly braces and here this is rectangular kind of bracket we are using. Now here after let's insert the record. No any errors. Here you can see CS, it's now rectangle kind of bracket and here this is the curly braces. Now here after there is the duplicate on add here or branch. This is a list tab and here this is set. Set also has duplicate values. Now if I try to enter or duplicate value, now here after press enter and here you can see. So add here by using list it accept duplicate value, but at here by using set it accept unique value. Now here after the next part is at here map. So it is used to store key value pair. It maps one thing to another. So at here let's understand by example creating table emp4. Now here after let's press enter and here after select start from. And here give the table name emp4. No any rows, two columns. Now here after insert into. So add here insert into expand key space emp4 table name add in column. So add is the 001 and here sub. So add here we can insert add here sub here after column 1 time 3 values. Now here after let's give add here. So values inserted. Now here you can see one ID and here this values. So this is the benefit at here. It is used to store key value pair. Multiple value we can enter at here. It maps one to another. Now here after let's copy this one. Now here after press enter and here emp4. So this time database MySQL it's inserted. Now here after let's insert CHE trash tags and here let's give ID value 3. Copy that and paste here. Value inserted, select star. So add in. It's accept. So if I enter right here CSV twice times, so accept twice. That means it accept duplicate values. So this is three important things: collection, set, list, and map. So right here about the map, it is used to store key value. So right here one time key, right here you can enter multiple. Math, physics, chemistry, English, biology, whatever you want, here you can insert. Database, MySQL, Oracle, Cassandra, PHP, everything you can insert. And after here you can see, you can give at your big data. After that you can insert Hive, Turbi, Cassandra. You can insert multiple values. Key pair of values. Key value pairs. Now press enter. Invalid request, invalid query message, undefined call. So right here, insert into expand emp3. Okay, we need to give emp4. That's why it's returning at your error. Now let's insert once again. So right here, emp3 already there. Now if I insert this one, so when you insert at your duplicate values next time, so it eliminate. Now here you can see three big data have turned in and here it's displayed. Now at your first time that I entered at your sub math, so let's see at your three sub math pages. Now here the ID it's not changed. Okay, first time at your here you can see three sub math chemistry that I entered. Now ID value change. So this is the best thing about at your Cassandra. So this is all about at your collection in Cassandra. So by using map collection, it is stored key value pair. And here, by using at your list collection, we can insert duplicate values. And here, about to set, it accept at your unique value and sorted format. Yeah. So I hope guys, this video is helpful for you. So now in this video, it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next week. Thank you.
Hi guys, in this video I'm going to discuss about materialized view in Cassandra. So about the materialized view, it is a database object that contains the output of a query. So let's understand by example. So at here I'm using NoSQL manager for Cassandra and here SQL editor. So first I'm going to create the table. So select that and execute. So executing statement. Now here after, so if you refresh at here, now here you can see T table it's created. If you take the cursor here you get the details. Now here after I am going to create materialized view. So at here execution time completed, no error. So at here SPAD is the key space and here T table is the table name. And here this all columns and primary key, ID, name and shape. So when you set at here ID, name and shape, so you should keep at here ID is not null and name is not null and shape is not null. So at here null primary key you can or it's not necessary to use is not null. Now here after there is one folder. So if you replace that folder, here you can see empty1 at here materialized view it's created. So create materialized view empty1 and here this all queries. Now here after, so see at here email. So email is the null primary key at here, but if I use at here email is not null, then we can create at here materialized view. Now here after execute that, so no any error. And here you can see md2 it's created and here take the cursor, here you can see this all details here. Now here after the next is create materialized view md3 and here country. So country is the non-primary key and here, but at this point I did not return country is not null. Now if I execute this query, let's see what happened. So at here getting the message cannot include more than one non-primary key
countries the matter as few primary key. So see idea, we cannot include more than one. So email is the non primary key at this place, and your country is the non primary key. So more than one non primary key that we cannot include at this place. So at your primary key, country, email is not primary key, but I said at this point, but here I written email is not null. So this is the one condition. Now here after create matter as we empty for. So ID now. So at here I applied add your ID and name. So add your ID and name is the primary key, but zip is also primary key. So when you are creating matter as view, so you should keep all the primary key. See idea, when I execute here, getting the error message, cannot create matter as be empty for without primary key. So zip is also primary key. Here you can see zip is also primary key. So you should keep zip. After that, you can create the matter as be. So at here I written zip is not null, but at here I did not include zip is not zip at here. So that here getting the error message. So this is the some condition to create the matter as be. So add here all primary key you should include, and here you need to set add here or is not null. So if you are using non-primary key, so here you should set add here email is not null, email include here. After that you can create, and more than one non-primary key we cannot include. So this is some condition. Now here after here, if you want to see add here record, so there is nothing inside there. Now here after I'm going to insert some record inside T-table. So at here generate command, and here insert and clipboard. Now here you can see insert into T-table. Now here I'm going to insert this record. So record inserted. Now here after let's go at this point, and when I execute this query, so here one record that is inserted. Now here after when I copy this one, copy, and if you keep at here select, so that I just created two matter as be empty one, empty one. Now if you execute this query, so at here when I execute select this all, and here empty one. So by executing this query, so this query it was percent on, it is a percent inside at here T table. The same thing it's come because at here I follow this at here select a start from T table, this all those things. So that it's a display. So all the content at here or table, it's not come inside matter as view. So this is the definition. It is a database object that contain output of a query. So it's object that contain output of the query. So at here, this is the output of T-table. So it's display. Now here after, if you want to display all matter as view, so you need to write select a start from system schema, and here if you execute, so there are two matter as view that I just created, empty one and empty two, and your base table ID, and your table name, and your change keys, and your key space. So all the detail you get by executing this query. System underscore schema dot view, memory plus mean index interval, all those things. Now there is a one thing. So if you create add a matter as view on the table T1, so when I try to delete this table, so let's delete that. So add here we cannot drop table when matter as view is still dependent. So this table add here dependent with two matter as view. So first you need to delete this two table. After that you can delete add here. Sorry, first you need to delete this two matter as view. After that you can delete this table. Now if you want to delete the table, right click on the table, sorry, if you want to delete the materialized view, right click on the materialized view here. Here you can see generate and here draw. You can use add here directly delete, or you can use add here generate. Secure item. So this is the query, drop materialized view, if not exit as client. Now if you execute this query, so add here executing a statement one of one. Now here after, let's request that. So add here materialized view empty to drop or deleted. So this is the simplest way we can create the materialized view on PSPS. So I hope guys this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you. Hello friends, today I'm going to discuss about how to connect Apache Cassandra with Razor SQL. So if you write add here Cassandra manage apps, so by using this command Cassandra started. So first you need to start the Cassandra. Now here after, let's double click on Razor SQL. So about the Razor SQL, so this is one create ID or here. So this available for 13 days. After that you need to buy. So I'm going to cancel. Now here after for new connection, click this. So add here connect to the database, or if you click add here add new database connection profile. So if you click add here you need to select add here database tab. So there are a bunch of different databases available, PostgreSQL, Oracle, RedShift, many more. So I'm going to select add here Cassandra. Now here after click on continue. So add here you need to select connection tab, JDBC, DDText, driver, it's fine. Now hereafter give the Cassandra profile name. So add here connect Cassandra. Now add here this is optional, and here authentication, login and password. So when you install add here Cassandra, so that time you get default password Cassandra and password Cassandra and user Cassandra, or you can give add here suitable user and password. So let's write add here Cassandra and Cassandra. Now here host, that is localhost, and here port 9042. Keyspace name. So if you want to find the keyspace name, first login CQLSS. Now here you can use any kind of keyspace. So let's enter at here S point. Now here you can find at here. So describe keyspace. So here you get all the keyspace that is in Cassandra. Now here after filling this all form. Now click on connect. So if you give all the information right, so add here Cassandra connected, and here you can see this all keyspaces. So this force are system created keyspace, and here this is created by me, user created. Now if you can check add here S point, and here this all tables, it's come now. So to creating add here keyspace, here you go create, here you can create tables. So add here if you want to create, add here create, here table generate, here create, export, this all option you can find add here. Now here you can use connect new connection, and here you can use db tables, create tables, alter, drop, edit, view, and here you can use describe. So when I click on describe, here database selected. So database similar to add here keyspace. So add here let's select S point keyspace. Now give the table name and here click on OK. So here you can see this is add here column name tag. Here you can see key country ID, and here this is the query that is detailed. So this is the one good ID for Cassandra. You should try. So I hope this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you.